The Olden World, written by Czar Yoshi. Chapter 53. Sword. Well, Gerardo began, giving Amber a glance as he straightened a few feathers that had gotten bent climbing for the window. I take it you have an agenda for a visit? Or is this merely a social call? Contented, he ruffled his wings and stood at attention. It's for breakfast, of course, Amber replied. Well, technically lunch, but you know. Hey, Maple, got anything cooking? Maple raised an eyebrow. As a matter of fact, I do. But why would you come here for my food when I live all the way on the other side of town? Amber shrugged. Happy coincidence. As the two grown mares began teasing each other, Starlight realized uncomfortably that Gerardo was staring at her. She folded her ears and met his gaze. Hi? Ah, Starlight. He stepped forward, extending a talon once he was in reach. I believe I haven't had a chance to thank you properly yet for saving my fortune during yesterday's fiasco, especially as it was at great apparent risk to your reputation. He bowed deeply. Please accept my sincerest thanks. Someone said you made everyone else leave me alone? Starlight asked, seeking confirmation. Well, we certainly gave him something else to think about, Gerardo said, brushing off a foreleg. Though most of the thanks goes to your friend Miss Amber over there. She was the one who traded her reputation for yours. He laughed and added, though if my reading of this town is correct, she'll be more a folk hero than villain by the time this blows over. She likely has been all along. It's readily apparent that she enjoys it after all. Starlight had nothing to say to that. After a moment of silence, Gerardo seated himself next to her and asked, if you don't mind me asking, what prompts you to lie low in a town like this? It seems to me the entire population either has pasts of their own or are used to not caring about others. I kind of do mind, actually, Starlight mumbled at the ground. Perfectly fair enough. Gerardo sat back and stretched, looking ahead. Queen knows there are many things I'd rather not answer about myself. Of course, for every one of them, there are 10 I love to talk about. Funny how that adds up, isn't it? He gave her a wink. Neither had to say anything for Starlight to get the impression that he very much wanted her to ask about whatever it was he didn't want to talk about. So she asked something else. What queen? Gerardo's head crest drooped. Apparently, she had read him right. Of the Griffin Empire, he explained disappointedly. The home of any griffin worth their griffinness. Myself included, of course. Huh. Starlight pursed her lips. She had expected something a lot more elaborate. And at that moment, they were interrupted when Willow hauled herself up the stairs. What's going on up? She blinked. How did all of you get up here? Oh, hey, Grandma, Amber chirped, waving happily. We came in for the window. The second-story window, Maple added with a roll of her eyes. Again? Grandma? Gerardo asked questioningly, tilting his head. You don't look that old. Willow sighed noisily. I'm not her grandma. It's a very long story, and that still makes me sound old. She climbed off the stairs, slightly unsteady on her hooves. Nevertheless, welcome to my home. The pleasure is mine, Gerardo replied, bowing neatly. You seem to be quite a tight circle of friends, and while star-struck fans have their merits, they don't make for nearly as pleasant company. Maple tapped a hoof. If you're going to stand around talking, maybe I should go finish lunch, because there's nobody working on it, and otherwise it'll never get done. A nobler task as any. Gerardo stepped cleanly out of her way. Please, by all means. As Maple vanished down the spiral staircase, Willow stepped closer and attempted to keep conversation going with a fatigued expression on her face. What did you do this morning? Gerardo beamed proudly. I spent an inordinate amount of time being fitted for and waiting for the completion of his new suit. Granted, time is presently the one thing I possess in excess. He craned his neck downwards, lifting the black fabric of his outfit with a single talon. What do you think? Willow eyed him blearily, blinking several times.
Sorry, I think I'm not really awake enough to judge, but... if it's made by Cyprus, I'm sure it's very quality...
She yawned heavily. Starlight eyed him properly as he showed off. The garment looked vaguely similar to a tuxedo or business suit, with a pronounced collar and shoulders and a professional-looking breast pocket. However, it was made from a material that looked significantly more durable and had some of the trappings of a military uniform. Notably, a long sash ran down the side, equipped with a large sheathed sword and plenty of room for more weapons. She had no doubt he knew how to use them. "Is that a sword?" she finally asked, curiosity getting the better of her. "And what a sword it is," Gerardo chuckled, withdrawing it with a nod. Glancing down the flat of the blade, he waved it several times. "What's a wandering hero without his magic sword, after all?"
"Excuse me," Elder's curious voice came from a nearby stairwell. "But did you say magic?"
"Totally did," Fur's voice interrupted. There was a yelp, and two children suddenly tumbled into view, one having apparently tripped over the other. They waved sheepishly.
"Magic, I did," Gerardo answered,
not in the least bit fazed by the new audience.
"To make things better, it even looks the part. Very detailed, black blade, a fancy hollow hilt."
He poked the talon through the triangular hole bored for the sword, right where the blade was attached, and waggled it for emphasis.
"It's as if it was designed to be a hero's sword. In fact, I'm fairly sure it was."
Starlight watched, transfixed, as light glinted off the sword's dark, smoky surface. It was likely because she had never seen a weapon bigger than a vegetable knife before, but something about the blade called to her, urging her to touch it. Feeling equal parts fear, yearning, and awe, she almost took a step forward to reach for it, but mentally slapped herself and sat back down. Becoming fascinated with things was a good way to accidentally earn a cutie mark, and she had no interest in herding ponies. Gerardo continued swinging it around, admiring the length and balance. "It's almost an exact replica of the kinds of swords in the greatest griffin epics. Thousands of years old, only the chosen may wield, that type of thing. The only thing that's missing is the history, and that matters little in a fight."
"And how do you know it isn't?" Amber asked, winking slyly and giving him a nudge.
"Because I bartered it off a unicorn whose specialty was in enchanting weapons," Gerardo said, smirking sadly. "Technically, off the daughter of such an enchantress who was helping her mother sell her wares. A cute little thing, if somewhat of a scruffy urchin. Similar in age to Starlight, I would guess."
Amber didn't lose her teasing grin.
"You buy from child merchants? How do you not get hustled?"
Gerardo shrugged.
"I know quality metal when I see it. Even if the enchantment had failed, a sword is still a sword, and a fine one at that. Besides, I no longer needed what I traded for it."
"But like, what's it do, though?" Fur asked excitedly. "How's it enchanted?"
"I can demonstrate, if you wish," Gerardo said with a smile. "I assure you, it's completely non-lethal, and the effect wears off rapidly." He blinked at Willow. "With your permission?"
Willow blinked back.
"If you're offering to test your sword on my kids," she growled, "not on your life, why can't you just explain it?"
Gerardo sagged slightly.
"I meant no offense, I assure—"
"Test it on Hemlock," Amber interrupted, pounding her hooves together with a shark-like grin. "Maybe after lunch?" Maple's face popped up above the staircase. "It's ready."
"Hey, sounds good to me," Amber muttered, still grinning as she made her way to the stairs.
Gerardo followed, and soon Willow was rounding up her kids and pushing them down as well. Starlight watched them descend, sighing. Her eyes were still fixed on the now sheathed sword, and this time, she found she couldn't tear them away.
"Starlight," Maple called from below, "you coming?"
"Yeah, I'm coming."
Breaking into a trot the moment Gerardo vanished from sight, she headed toward the staircase, trying instead to focus on thoughts of an early, tasty lunch. End of chapter 53.